Hi everyone, my name is Khennisa Saputri and I would like to present our work on titled Shapley Value for Green Supply Chains Profit Distribution. And these are three persons that working behind this paper. The supply chain is the complete organization chain from OEM to end consumer, with flows and transformations of products, information, and money. And every activity carried out by the players has the potential to generate stress for the environment. And based on these concerns, the manufacturing industry implements the green manufacturing idea, also known as the green supply chain concept. The green supply chain itself is a supply chain that consists of a forward and a reverse supply chain, with the process beginning with manufacturing and ending with the recovery of discarded items into the new ones. In green supply chain, any party may gain more if they collaborate and establish coalitions. And depending on this, the Shapley value approach is utilized as a solution to estimate the distribution of benefits depending on the contribution to the established coalition. In our article, we'll discuss the green supply chain model and mathematical formulation, and then followed by an example of its application and an analysis of its findings. We've construct five different models. These are a model without coalition, and then the full joint coalition, and three different partial coalition. Before we construct our model, we have decided what assumptions will be in our model. The first one will be the third party gathered each product from consumer and then being processed by the UAM. And then the price of new product and wholesale price of new product, the cost of refurbishing and manufacturing, and the price of collecting each product are constant. The second assumption, we have two market segments that are high-end and low-end market. Another assumption, we have refurbishing should be naturally be less expensive than manufacturing. And then the last one, we have all used product can be refurbished. This is the variable and the parameters we used in our study. The first model we have without coalition. This is the profit functions of each players. And then this is the Shapley value of each player on screen. And by using Stackelberg game with a backward induction procedure, we have this optimum solution for this model. The first partial coalitions between the OEM and the retailer. And this is on screen, we have a Shapley value of this model. And by using Stackelberg game and procedure backward induction, we have our optimum solution for this model. The second partial coalition model, we have manufacturer and the third party. This is the Shapley value of this model. The same as previous with Stackelberg game and backward induction procedure, we have this optimum solution of this model. The last partial coalition model, we have coalition between retailer and the third party. And this is the Shapley value of this model. Another model that we construct is complete coalition model. This is the coalition between the OEM and then the retailer and the third party. This is, we have the Shapley value of this model. For the profit distribution, we use a Shapley value method. This is a method to solve the end player in a cooperative game. This is the Shapley value of the OEM. And then this is the Shapley value of the retailer on screen. And then the last one is for the third party. We already decided our value of parameter. This is the player's revenue. And then from table 7, we have that the profit for each player in complete coalition is greater than the profit for each player without a coalition. This is the revenue distribution can be expressed as follow on screen. And finally, we have construct our 5 different models. These are without coalition and complete coalition, and 3 models with a different partial coalition. And then the Shapley value approach is utilized as a solution to estimate this distribution of the benefits depending on the contribution of the established coalition. And based on numerical analysis, it is obtained that the profit for each player without a coalition model less than the profit in a complete coalition model. And this is the references we use in this study. And finally, that's all from me. Thank you so much for your attention.